All right, so I keep getting emails and comments about RSS, really simple syndication. That's a standardized way to do feeds and blog feeds and news feeds on the internet. And people keep asking, oh, how do I use this? How do I subscribe to RSS feeds? How do I set any of this up? How do I run my own RSS feed? I'm gonna be addressing those questions in today's video. Firstly, we'll take a look at how to subscribe to RSS feeds and how to use all that. And secondly, we're gonna take a look at how to run your own RSS feed. If you wanna skip directly to that, there's a timestamp in the description that you can follow and go straight to the part where I teach you how to actually run your own RSS feed. But in the meantime, I'm going to show you how to add RSS feeds, how to subscribe to them in Thunderbird. All right, so before you actually set anything up with RSS feed, you need a feed to subscribe to. I don't know, let's say I want to subscribe to CNN Africa, right? Just right click on this, copy the link address, and go to Thunderbird. So in Thunderbird, you can add a dedicated RSS account. So I'm gonna go to the little hamburger menu over here, click new, and then go to feed account. I'm gonna just leave the default name, that's fine. I'm gonna click finish, and there you go, there's my feed account. If I click manage feed subscriptions over here, or if I right click on it and click subscribe, this menu opens up over here where I can add RSS feeds to subscribe to. Now the URL for CNN's Africa RSS feed is this one over here, so just make sure you copy paste that one, so you know, copy it right there. Go down here to feed URL and paste it right there, click add, and boom, there's 27 articles in CNN Africa. So I'm just gonna close this over here, go to my feeds and go to the CNN one, and there, I can start reading CNN Africa articles. There's images and stuff in it that you can read, and this is how RSS feeds work. If CNN publishes a new article, they will update their RSS feed, and if I go over here and press F5, as you can see, for a little while it flashed because it's updating, or you can right click on it and click get messages. It's gonna go to the website and check the RSS feed file itself and see if there's any updates. Now in this case, there aren't any because I just subscribed to it. All the latest stuff is gonna be there. However, in a day or so, or even just in an hour, there might be some new updates from CNN Africa over here. All right, so that's how you subscribe to RSS feeds, at least in Thunderbird. Most RSS feed readers will be similar. Just copy paste the link and boom, you're subscribed. Now let's take a look at how to run your own RSS feed. So one way to make an RSS feed is to take a script like what we're going to be taking a look at today, which is Luke Smith's SUP script, this one over here, and have it automatically take any HTML file and add that to an RSS feed. Because once again, an RSS feed is just an XML file that has all the articles in a list, and every time there's a new one, it just gets added onto that. So that's what this essentially will do, this SUP script. You can give it any HTML file, and it's gonna translate it to XML and add it to your existing RSS file. Okay, so as you can see, I got a basic little website over here. Hey, it's a basic site. I have an RSS feed file. It's empty at the moment. As you can see, this is the default one that comes in Luke Smith's LB repository, which I linked in the description. There you can download the rss.xml file and the SUP script file, which is what we're going to be using to actually run our RSS feed. And there's also a little article which I will be adding to the RSS feed so people, you know, can see it. So the first thing to do is to customize our RSS feed. So if you go to vim rss.xml, there's a few things to set in here. Like for example, we don't really need a style sheet. We could just delete that line. Well, you can have it, but you don't really need it. The title, I'm just going to call this Stenshi's Test RSS Feed. Description, a brief description, I'm just call it, I don't know, I'm testing out RSS. You can also add icons and stuff. If you wanna know how to do that, you can check it out on my RSS feed, rss.xml right there. And as you can see for the icon, I just copy pasted this part over here. I'm just gonna have a link to the RSS feed, which you can set over here. As you can see, it says your website. I'm gonna change this to rss.danshi.org because that's the website, and rss.xml is the RSS feed. That's the basic things you need to set in here, your title, your description, and the link. Note this little part over here, this comment that says LB, the subscript needs to see this so it knows where to put the article, so do not delete that. All right, so we can right quit that. And then another file we gotta take a look at is the subscript itself, so vim into sup or whatever text editor to use. I'm gonna change the website link over here to rss.danshi.org, and the RSS file, it's rss.xml, that's the default one, so that should be fine. Anyway, so now just colon right quit, and that should be all in terms of editing scripts and files. Now let's actually add something to our RSS feed. But before we do any of that, let's actually add our RSS feed to Thunderbird so we can test it out when it comes out. So going back to Thunderbird over here, the manage feed subscriptions, the feed URL should be this one over here. This is just the one that I created temporarily. I'm gonna copy paste it there, add, and there it is, Denshi's Test RSS feed. It even got the name correct. So when my article comes out, I'll be able to see it here once I reload the page. Anyways, let's actually add our article. We're going to run the subscript. There it is, sup. And we're going to add the file article.html. So pressing enter. It should have done it. Now let's reload the page. There's the article added right there. Now let's reload over here on Thunderbird. And there's the article. Article. Hey, look, it's an article. Look, an image. And it even has a little image that I put there. So that's how you run an RSS feed. This is a script by Luke Smith called sup that essentially takes HTML files and transforms them to XML and puts them in your RSS feed. But there's tons of other scripts similar to this that do the same thing, or whole scripts that add a blog system, which in addition give you a page for your blogs and actual HTML alongside an RSS feed. The world of running your own RSS feed is really, really big, so I recommend taking a long and slow look at it, but this is a fast little way to upload a file to an RSS feed and get people to start reading your articles. But anyways, I've been Denshi. That was how to use RSS and how to run your own RSS feed. Goodbye.